Hello friends, I hope you are doing fine. Today we will make a twisted trap bit in SolidWorks. I hope you like it. Let's see how to do in SolidWorks. It's simple and widely used trap bit. M14 by 1.5 mm Dormer trap bit. So let's see how to do this in SolidWorks. So now let's start here. We will make M14 by 1.5 mm trap bit. So select here right plane, sketch, and start, choose here line, and I will start above the line up to origin, escape, delete line, and start from origin, it's better. Okay, exit. Now let's define this geometry. 75 mm. This side wall, let's keep 7.5 mm. 40 mm. Let's keep in proper position. Keep 4 mm and keep the length 12 mm. Okay, now here select revolve boss base. Select the bottom line as axis. You can see it here. Okay. Let's define the raw material. Satin finish stainless steel. Okay, that's fine. Choose chamfer, keep 2 mm and select this face. Okay, that's it. Now here we want to make some groove or some cutouts, so we will do one thing. Select this face, sketch, normal, and let's draw a geometry. First make center line. Okay, now choose here line, connect up to this line and little go above the circle and convert it into an arc. Exit. Now the basic thing, 3.4 mm and this one by default may be 4 mm. It's by default. And outside you can keep anything, it's up to you. This length also you can keep anything. Now the geometry is fully defined. Choose here fillet. Keep 0.5 mm and select this corner. That's it. Now simply exit. Now just take right plane, sketch. Okay. Now select line here and draw a little tapered line, not horizontal, little tapered, and convert this end into arc. Exit. Center line and draw here a straight horizontal line. Exit. Select the line, construction line, and make relation horizontal. Now let's make the angle between this 0.88 degree. It's a small angle. And keep the length 60 mm and let's say radius 10 mm. And okay, take this circle little out. This is the path for thread cutting, not thread cutting, it is for passage cutting. So simply exit. Now select here swept cut. Now you can see the path is selected. Just select the profile. So this is our triangle profile. See, it's going to cut here. Okay. Now it's cut. We need multiple number of these patterns. Select here circular pattern and directly select this cutout, or you can select it from here also And now here there are many options, either select a circular face or select axis. So let's select any circular face. This is circular. Three numbers, 360 degree equal spacing. Okay. Today is my computer is slow, so okay. Now you can see we cut three flutes here. That's it. Now we want to twist it. So here you will find one option, twist. I think if you will not find here, just go to insert feature and you will find here flex. See, select the body here. Here select twisting and degree 180 degree. Then come down and here, okay, this here the dimension is perfect, no need to define anything. Select okay. Now it's going to twist. You can see it here. See, it is twist. Due to twist, some portion is higher, some is lower. So we want to trim upper face. Select this face, sketch, circle, and find out the midpoint and draw one circle here. And keep the diameter 14 mm. Okay. Now select extruded cut. Keep long 65 mm. And select here flip side to cut. We want to cut above the outside of circle. See, it's going to cut some surfaces. Okay. Now here it's cut the surfaces. Now it's become perfect. Now it's time to create the thread. First we will create a plane. Plane. Select this face. Keep 10 mm in this direction. Okay. Now select this plane. Sketch. And previous circle also there. You can select this previous circle. Sketch 4. And convert entities. Now see, it's converted here. Now for creating thread we need to find out the path, so I prefer helix and spiral. Now see here, keep height and pitch constant. Pitch height I prefer 70 mm, and pitch 1.5 is sufficient. 180 degree reverse direction clockwise. This one known as taper because we want to create a straight thread. Okay, now here the thread is created. Now hide this plane. Now we want to create some profile. So let's choose here right plane, sketch, normal. Go to surface and here select polygon. And here you will keep three number of parameters, inscribe circle and draw exit. Select the bottom line, horizontal relation, that's it. Now let's define. (0.9195 mm). It's a small circle, not too big. Select here fillet. (0.216) and select this end. Okay. That's fixed. Now select smart dimension and select the distance from here to this point. Keep 14.2 mm. This is quite better, 14.2 mm. Now select exit. And select here swift cut. Let me select the profile and select this path. After selecting this path, you will see the preview here. See, select here, OK. Now, after calculation, it will cut the thread around the body. Now you can see here, see, we cut here threads. Keep remember, we are going to make a tab bit, twisted tab bit. Now it's time to extend this face. So select here right plane, sketch, select line, and start from midpoint to endpoint. Go little up. And connect again midpoint. Okay, now let's define it. Keep 10 mm, 35 mm, and keep the length only 5 mm. Now the geometry is fully defined. So select here revolve boss base. Keep merge result. Okay. Now select this face, sketch. First define center point, because it's always difficult to find. Okay, so this is the center point. Choose here center rectangle, draw a rectangle and define it 7 by 7. Even you can select the with the help of now select extrude and extrude only up to 10 mm. See here, merge result. Okay, fillet 0.2 and select this outer corner. Okay, now here we want to make some sharp edge. So the same procedure, right plane, and I will draw a free geometry. Start from midpoint, okay. I'll not give any dimension, it's a free geometry. It's up to you how you will manage it. Now select here revolve cut. You can select this line as an axis. Select here, OK. Now we made it a sharp edge here. See, this is the sharp edge. Now this is the our twisted tap bit. If we will do one thing, we will make some naming here with embossing function. So choose right plane, sketch, and let's start to draw. Choose center line. Exit. Select here text, select line, and write here text. This is Dormer brand tab bit, Dormer M14 by 1.5 mm. Here mid center align selected, uncheck and choose the font. We want to keep the font let's say 2.5, or keep bold, select 2.5, this is better, bold 2.5. okay, now exit and go to here feature, and here you will find wrap command. There are many options, emboss, deboss, or but normally it is deboss. this is the face, and debose 0.2 mm. That's it. Select here, okay. That's it. Now you can see here it is a debose inside. Select this and you can choose the color so it helps to identify. Okay. So this is the Dormer tab bit. I hope you like it. Please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Don't forget to share and like our videos. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.